我不知道我们两个。
啊，这样你有invite人家进来吗？
嗯，开始。
Hello, everybody. Are we online or not?Okay, so together with me, I think there's Tracy.
Yeah, I'm Tracy.
And then I'm Yan Jingquan. Okay, maybe I do a self-introduction. I joined NUS about 20 years ago. I'm one of the earlier people who...
Should we wait for more people to join first?
Okay, I think, we will wait for another 3 minutes or 2 minutes and then to start to allow more people to come in. Okay, I think maybe we should start. Sorry about the delay because some technical difficulty. We are not familiar with the Instagram, so in the end, me and Tracy all, I think you need to sit slightly, yeah, all need to sit together and then to talk to you guys. So I am Yan Jingquan. I'm the professor in the Division of Industrial Design for, and I joined the division about 2002, so until now it's about 18 years. So I'm one of the earlier people who joined the division. So here, today we are in CUTE Center. I'm the co-director in the Keio-NUS CUTE Center. In this center, we do a lot of different type of things. Try to talk about how do we use virtual reality, augmented reality, even tangible interaction to help people to see how can we create a better life or to create something different. So for example, like for this COVID, the 3D printing swab is come from my center, which now I think is widely in use in Singapore. Yeah. So next to me is Tracy.
Yeah, hi, I'm Tracy. I recently graduated last year. And now I'm like working at CUTE as a design researcher. Yeah. So I mainly work in designing like the user studies, and but I also work on like different projects that's more interaction based or use like augmented reality and yeah, different projects. So maybe we can look at the questions.
Okay, so maybe we try to answer you some question first.
There was one that asked, hi, would someone with no design portfolio still be accepted?
Okay, in the interview, right, we haven't decided what is the interview format for this year. It could be online. But before we do for the interview, that means we will ask you to submit the information. So the information is now little about in the admission. So in later stage, there's another... notification for those people with your list. So we will ask them to submit their portfolio or other type of things. So it's not too late at this moment. So you still can try to do your portfolio, and then if you are short list, and then you can send to us.
Oh. So what's the but do you have to have a design portfolio?
Okay. So for the student, come from A level, normally you don't have a portfolio, so it's quite okay. But for example, if you before we have some people come from art background, they want to show their art work during their secondary school or other things, it's quite okay. We are quite welcome. And some people, they may show their leisure activity. Maybe somebody love to do some craft type of things, or they want to do something for photography. We also very welcome. You want to show us all these things, yeah. But it's not really a compulsory for a level student require a portfolio.
Yeah, I think you could just show anything that it's related to what you did. Like, yeah, it can be any sketches or any drawings that you did as hobbies, but it's good to show, yeah, what you're interested in and why you chose design. That's like other question. Okay, I guess we can ask you. What is too much for a portfolio?
Okay, I think very simple is you think about in the interview, right? The time is limited. So even though we may want to review everybody's portfolio, everybody's information, but every time we have shortlist few hundred students, so you will see how long each professor can spend the time. So if you have a very long portfolio and then but we need to spend long time but cannot find the focus, that'll be too long. So you need to try to see that in American, we talk about elevator talk or we talk about other things. How do you have a portfolio which is strong, sweet and short, which can grab the attention, rather than you have a very long portfolio but we just cannot find the important point which you want to address. Yeah, Tracy, can you talk about your experience in the school? You can talk about presentation, your craft and presentation. I think in DID, we also talk about craft and right, when you go out, a lot of people want to have a long presentation, but in DID craft and we only do a 3 minutes to 5 minutes presentation. Because that's the part we try to train the student how to provide a concise information and then to show the best part of yourself. Sorry, before coming. Okay, so there's another student asked, what is the things before you come in, anything related to design? I think design is also the appreciation and it's a lifestyle. So often, right, if you are able, some of people, they love to go to any design museum or any museum or other art gallery. I think that's quite good. And then, but you also can come from your life experience to learn, for example, try to understand what's the difference between different use of something else. So it's really depend on what sort of designer you want to be, what sort of things you want to help. So often, we will encourage your student have a different type of life experience, which allow you to have a different way to empathy the people and then to provide something different and then to have a different type of unique point.
Like, I think for me, when I joined, I didn't really know much about design, but like even in my perspective, even as someone who don't know much about design, I think eventually you still develop your own unique perspective. So I think it's okay even if you don't necessarily know exactly what kind of designer you want to be or anything, but I guess it's kind of to keep like an open mind and to have be able to see different perspectives in design. Yeah.
There is a lot of questions.
What? Okay, I think I saw a question. I think quite a lot of people always ask this question to see what do they need to prepare for interview. you can go to our division website. There's a interview preparation kit. Well, in for us, right, we try to some sort of much more informed choice as well as informed consent. And then we want to see some of the information. For example, in our preparation kit, we did put lots of different video, allow you to understand there's a variety type of design. Not only talk about maybe design is only design something like a furniture or something, but then over there there's including service design, including critical design, including 3D printing or all other different type of application for design. So in a way, in the preparation kit, we want the student can really go through all different type of video, and then we can discuss with the student what's their viewpoint. Because quite often, as a designer, you need to create or you need to try to have your own understanding about different things rather than we want to have a unique answer. So from the preparation kit, it's something quite good point or good starting point allow you to do a preparation for the interview.
What are you guys looking for in a potential DID student?
Okay, I think it's also go back to just now what I mentioned. We try to see, well, as a designer, right, depending on what type of designer you want to be. So for example, if you want to do service design, quite often you need to see things through other people's eyes. And then you need to be able to do an empathy and then to understand people's needs. But for example, if you want to become a much more lifestyle type of designer, we are looking for the people who have a stronger aesthetical sense, and then they are able to justify and then to articulate why they want to design things in this way. So it's really depend on your own focus, as well as and then how can we try to understand your focus and how do we try to find the talent can match the focus you want.
What are the differences between students that came from JC and students from Poly?
Okay, it's an interesting question. Basically, right, we have this view. I won't talk about this. Is two different type of student, but we do have even IB student. The IB student also the other type of student. They have a different type of background. So JC student quite often you will see a student. They start from first year. And then they are not direct entry. But poly students, if they are come from design related background, they may direct entry second year. So for those students, it's an interesting culture shock for our JC intake or the first year intake. It's because suddenly they will see somebody have a much higher level of a technical skill. They can draw quite well. Their rendering, their cadence is much stronger. But it doesn't mean say, okay, they have a better skill level, they are able to do some better than our JC student. Because JC student, in the other way, like just now I mentioned, they are come from academic background. So in a way, I think NUS are quite different from other people's. NUS have very strong research culture. So that's the reason why you can see our alumni. Rather than they can do user research, they can do for different type of design research very well, and then they can be employed in the company in this reason, rather than they are only focused on design itself. So somehow the academic background, they help the student to find another niche for design. The other one is for JC student. We do have some other students, so for example, you may get a chance like another tutor who just get his PhD from American. So basically he's very strong in academic background and very strong in mathematics. And then he used mathematics in the end, he are able to use that to design something. and then which can become a very value add in design field, which is normally we can't see in design field before. So that is a one for JC student. Because of an academic background, allow them create some sort of a different different type of input, and then which is different from traditional design school. And for the poly student, quite often we can see they are much more practical in some certain sense because of a skill level they have. But we also try to see is how can we really educate a poly student with higher so-called strategic level. So in a way, that means they are not only the one implement something, but they are able to, in the company, they can offer and become a leading person. So that is a part we try to see, and then we hope our poly student can be. Yeah.
Yeah, I think maybe the difference between the JC and the poly student mainly is just different in strength, like what they are good at. And I think both have like their own unique experience and like their own viewpoint that they can kind of imbue into what they design and their projects. And I think both, yeah, it's just mainly like both have their own strengths. And yeah, if you are a JC student, then maybe when you first joined in year one, you might struggle a bit because you have to like learn all the fundamentals and all the skills such as sketching or CADing. But I think, yeah, I guess it's part of the journey, like the struggle, but you get to struggle along with other your friends. So, and I think design is also that you will never stop learning. So Even now, we're still learning, so you'll always be learning like new skills and new techniques. So in a sense, you're always like a beginner, like you're always learning new things. So it's okay even if you don't know anything or like, or you lack the skills at the start, you can always put in the effort. And I think eventually the JC students, a lot of them do thrive and like do manage to do very well in DID as well. So I don't think you have to worry about, oh, if I don't know anything, I don't have the skills. But yeah, you will, if you really want to do design, you'll eventually find a way. So yeah, don't worry. Yeah.
How about you suggest something or question? Right. I think, yeah, if you have questions, could you submit it through the question mark icon? Yeah, rather than through comments so that I could see the questions. And pin it. How much should I get to get into NUS? I'm from IB board. You mean the points? Maybe can ask.
I think every year is slightly different, because NUS is based on, for us it's based on the position, and so it's competitiveness type of things. But no, I did not really know what is a cut off, because I don't think there's a publication for the IB student. They do have a so-called graduate indicator for A level and poly, but I don't think we have a IB student number.
Yeah, I'm not sure. Maybe they, can they ask?
I think you can, if you really want to know, you may try to check with the office admission to see. Yeah.
How is the learning culture like?
How is the learning culture like in DID? Okay, DID is interesting type of education program compared to all other, I think all other programs in NUS. We have something we call a studio culture. All the students, mostly, okay, because our project is based on studio. And then in the studio, we have something called platform. So in the platform is a year 2, 3, 4, they work together. Yeah. So quite often is a very interesting culture, allows this sort of so-called vertical integration, allow them to be able to work with different year. I think that's something quite rare to see in the other department. And then because everybody work in a same project. So you will see the classmate or the even senior, junior, they are very close because they may work for some project together. And then we also, based on this so-called peer pressure or peer study, the students are able to learn something different. And then the senior, they are able to play some sort of role which can be mentor or other thing to help the younger or junior student. So that creates something quite interesting type of culture in the whole DID. And then in a way, it's much more like a big family rather than individual people.
Yeah, because ID is quite small. Like usually it's around 30 plus to like
40
yeah,
plus.
Like 40 yeah. plus, that which is like the bigger numbers. So usually when everyone knows everyone, like across the years, we also like mostly know everyone. So yeah, so we do get to interact across the years. So sometimes juniors might have like questions or yeah, things that they're not sure, then they can just ask the seniors. Yeah, so it's quite open, like an open culture. Yeah.
We did have a culture to stay overnight, but this new year, we are quite consider the workload of a student, so it's much less now.
But I think people, sometimes you stay overnight because, like, there's a certain, like with the project, we have a certain vision that we want to achieve. That's why we keep pushing towards, like, even though it's kind of done, but we want it to be even more perfect. That's why people, and because in a sense it's a little bit, it's a friendly competition because everyone push everyone to kind of do your best. So yeah, so everyone will.
Okay, some people ask for the job perspective, right? I think in one way, if you want to know or you want to see, if you want to purely as a designer, of course, it's not so many jobs in Singapore. But if you want to see, you want to work, you want to use design to help different discipline or different industry, there's a lot of job. So since I joined NUS, at that time, I think mostly we try to see how can we train designer to help industry. But of course, that is much more so-called the product designer. But after that is, of course, the number is limited. But we start to see how can we find a way to influence the whole industry in Singapore. So we move into service design, move into UI, UX, so we move into different type of area for design. So you are able to see now, for example, like DBS, OCBC Bank, they have an innovation team. So that means in financial, in the financial area, they also start to use design and then see how can design help them. And then you can see, for example, like Grad, Shopee, they have a UI UX team as well as a user experience team. So they require the designer to help them to provide a better interface. But they also require a designer to provide a new user experience type of design. So that is totally different from before how we talk about designer. And then, so in hospital now, you also can see, for example, SingHealth, National Health Group, and NUHS, they start to have an innovation group. So they try to see how can they use the design to help their service, to help the medical device, to enhance the whole quality of the healthcare. So in this way, right, you will start to see the designer, they are contribute in a very different way. They are not only talk about a traditional way of product, they are also help in the different level type of a service or even different level type of a strategic thinking. So even if you go to Prime Minister office, there's another user experience design team, which they need to help the whole government to see how can they provide a better interface for them to talk to people or for them to, so for example, say for MOM, how do they create a better queuing service for the people who go to use the public service. polyolefins. So that create a very unique point for the designer, allow the designer to contribute and then to help the whole society into a very different level.
Yeah, because I think design in the end is like, it's a way of thinking and seeing things. So when you're educated in design, there's like a certain thing that you can bring to the table across different industries that does contribute something to help them. So yeah, by pure design, you meant like product design.
Yeah.
So design, I think, yeah, currently a lot of industries do value the kind of thinking that designers can bring into.
So you can see this few years getting more and more, like just like I mentioned, have Sharpie, IBM, even business consultancy like McKinsey, they all employ designer. Yeah, because designer have another angle of view things, and then designer can provide a bridge between the user and manufacturer or the business owner.
Someone asked, can we choose to design our major on our final year?
Okay, in the what do you mean major in the final year? Okay, I don't understand the major you mentioned about. If you talk about a specialty in IT, we don't have that. Quite often is we have the thesis project allow you to be hands on or specialized in something. So quite often that's a thesis project for, yeah, for the final year thesis, yeah. So in a way, it's much more we talk about a specialization rather than a major.
Yeah, and because the way the studio works is there's different types of design. Like there is service design, there is spatial design, or there's like product design. So you could choose based on like your interests. Maybe you can choose to keep taking the same kind of studios, like doing the same type of design, like such as product design. So in a sense, you are specializing in that kind of design. Yeah, but you don't choose your major in your final year.
Yeah, if you really talk about the new news just announced, right? I think normally you need to choose your major about in the earlier year, in the second year or third year. Because you still require about 10 courses. 10 module, so it's not really say 1 year you can complete. It takes more than 1 year. I think it's about 2 years or two, or more than 2 years. So if you talk about the one just announced, that means you need some more time to digest and then to complete that major, a new major. Yeah.
Someone asked, is Masters in Product or Industrial Design available?
Okay, in NUS so far, we don't have a top course master. We only have a research master and PhD. Yeah. So far our student, if they want to consider a top course master, then they will go to the other country. Like went to UK for RCA, or some people may go to USA for Carnegie Mellon, Georgia Tech, all those schools. But we did plan to do a master program. But we don't know when will that be started yet, but it's in the planning.
For
research masters? research master different. And PhD master is much more based on the research rather than based on coursework. Yeah.
Someone asked, are projects mostly done individually or are there quite a few group projects?
Okay. I think that just like I mentioned, in our education, we have something called Prof. So in the Prof, from our past few year experience, so we try to do now is in each semester, you need to choose two different topics. And one topic need to be teamwork and one topic need to be individual work. So in that case, right, allow you to really, after graduate, you know how to work with other people and how do you contribute in the team. But we also want to see individually you have a special technique as well as a knowledge. So that's a part we want you to contribute in your individual project.
Someone asked, And for in year one, like fundamentals, mainly it's individual, right?
Year one is mainly individual. So, it's always starting from year two to year four. That'll be a more about half a project of making work. But it's also provide a student who can really serve as in the same team. They could be a senior designer, junior designer. So there's a much more better of an integration.
Submit our design portfolio.
Okay, yeah. For those people who have been shortlisted, right? I think depending on what is the interview method this year. So in the later, we will tell you how do you upload your portfolio or up to you upload your interview material.
Can I transition into a different career? After this program? What do you mean by different career?
Okay.
Design
is versatile and very flexible. And then, interesting, depending on how do you want to talk about transition? So for example, we have a student just graduated about last year or 2 years ago. He is basically a banker, or come from financial industry, and then until 40 something, and then he decided to change his career, and then he chose design. So that sounds like a very interesting experience for him, and a very interesting experience for us. And then we also have some people who work, for example, from Polytechnic, and then after that he went to some scholarship, and then now work for SDF, and then that's an interesting type of career for him to move as well. So it's really depend on what you're talking about, what do you mean? And then if you talk about after study design, and then we do have people, for example, because of design, and then he used design thinking, went to banking, or went to other area. And then after that, continue and then become a vice president in the company, which he may not no longer doing design. So it's also a career change. So it's really depend on what is the angle you are talking about.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Has there been an instance where an applicant was rejected after an interview?
But
cannot see the full question. But what? Reapplied next year.
Okay. It did have this sort of chance. I think if I guess correctly, okay. Well, for the male, right? For the male student, quite often you can apply 3 times after you graduate. From JC, and then after that you go to NS first time and second time, second year NS second first year second year, and then come to after that you leave NS. So normally you have three times to apply, and because of a different year, the student who apply they slightly different. So sometimes this year this student may come in, but next year may not come in. Or sometimes last year, because for example, say, year dragon or something else, there's so many students apply, so that means the selection will be very, very tough. And then, but the next year could be much less student to apply, so that will be, so in the end, it's a competitiveness type of basis. So sometimes it did get a chance, say, this year have been rejected, and then they come in next year because of the application number. But also because of some people may prepare, say, for example, some JC students, they don't have a portfolio. But after that, in the first year, they learn something, and then they try to really bring their portfolio and then to show their best point of view, and then we may try to accept the student as well. So it really depends on the performance you have as well.
Trying. Someone
accepted
their second.
Alright. You can keep trying. And then even come to NUS, you still can apply for transfer.
Yeah. You can change major.
Yeah.
Yeah. What?
No. No.
Concurrent degree, memorable project, the one with the students.
Okay, this one is quite interesting. You talk about memorable project. I think it really depends on during their school time or after that they graduate. I think there are some of the students after they graduate, they do some fantastic project. So for example, I have one student who involved in the OCBC bank, the whole website revamping. It's very interesting, and when you talk about the whole idea, they contribute, that's quite good. And then you also can see, for example, one of our lecturer, senior lecturer, Dong Ko, he was my student for the thesis, and then his project, Leaf Block, for the CP children, is one of the outstanding project, won lots of major international competition. And then also now had been licensed, and then one of a company based on the concept and modified, and then now there's a product on the market which also won the Australian Design Award and German something else. Yeah, so that could be also quite interesting. And then I have another student, Ethan Chow. Basically, right, his work had been selected by World Economic Forum, and then went to attend the World Economy Forum to discuss why he wants to design something to help people. The project he did is the one to help the immobilized patient to move their body to reduce the pain. So, and as a result, the caregiver, that is the parents at this moment, they can really have much better quality of life, and then the patient themselves also improve their quality of life. Yeah. So it's really depend on the project and depend on the angle. So some of the project then maybe have a very good commercial success. Some of the project then may really do something good for the human being. But of course, as a designer, in one way, I love to see how the student can really contribute to help the people, to help the people in need, and then to change people's life through design. Yeah, your project also one of the project can help people. Your thesis. Yeah.
My thesis.
Okay, one student is about the concurrent degree or at this moment concurrent degree only architecture they have. That means is they are able to register in architecture and after they graduate as a master degree. So that's only architecture. I think we don't have this option. But if you read today's newspaper, there will be a choice for you to have a second major, and then also minor or specialization, which I think NUS try to do our best to allow the student can. I think the other way we should say we try to train a t-shirt designer, allow the designer or allow the people who have a variety type of skill, not only one type of skill, and then they are able to build a much more better type of foundation to go for the career.
My thesis is very cool.
Thanks.
When working with consumer electronics, is the lack of technical knowledge in IT ever a big problem? Technical, like engineering knowledge?
Okay, I think it's really depend on the student as well as the area you want to work through. And then a lot of project, right, I will tell you, say, even until my, until now, I'm facing a lot of project which I don't know. I have no idea about the technical issue. So myself, I do a lot of medical project. And then so I'm not really the medical student. So if the people tell me these things want to help some sort of patient for some sort of illness, unless you are a medical student, you will understand everything. But for us as a designer, we have been trained to see how can we look for information very fast, how can we see things in a critical way, and how can we conduct a so-called contextual study to understand the user, and then to, from the ethnography type of idea, to build a better user scenario. So, and then so in that case, we are able to design something which is much more fulfill the requirement of the user, rather than we come in without any knowledge and never do something which user doesn't like. So quite often in the training of the 4 years, that is a part allow us to see how can we learn and then to do something within a very short period of time and then to get the background information for different type of project.
But I think he meant in consumer electronics. I think maybe engineering.
But consumer electronics, for me, it's okay. Technical. If you talk about a technical part, it's similar to that just I mentioned for the medical project. So for consumer electronics, we need to talk about the background of the technology type of understanding. And then you want to understand whether, for example, it's a IoT, and then the IoT has a new technology or something else. But in a way that just I mentioned, we try to teach you how do you do benchmarking faster, how do you try to see, how do you find the different information to assist you to do different type of project. Because, for example, if you work for a design consultancy, today you may receive a project to tell you, say, now you want to design something for maybe T4 or the new T5 customer check-in kiosk. And then the next day, maybe somebody tell you, say, I want you to help me to do an airport control interface. And then the next day, somebody come in to tell you, say, I want to design a new mouse. So it's all very different. But how can you tell people, say, oh, sorry, oh, I did not learn the control for the airport before, so I don't know how to design. Yeah, as a design consultant, you won't do that. That means you will try to see how do you use a short this time to find the information and then allow you to find a way to propose something rather than we just constrained by the so-called technicality or by the problem which we think about it become a barrier for us to do any design.
Yeah, because not just designer, like I don't think someone can maybe know everything, yeah, about like different subjects. Yeah. So I think as a designer, you have to be able to I guess learn very quickly, maybe about different industries or different things that you might need. So yeah, we do learn about research. Yeah, in a sense, research is very important to be able to know what is possible or what you need to learn or what you don't know about a certain subject so that you can design better for it. But yeah, that's why designer, you're always learning. Never ending.
Yeah, I think the time is nearly end, and then I think I can answer one or two more questions. Any other question? What is the average number?
Is it difficult to adapt to DIY being a JC?
That's right.
You
can
ask me.
Okay, you talk
about. I think someone asked, is it difficult to adapt to DIY being a JC student without any design background? think previously I did mention something. I think at the start there's a bit of difficulty, especially because I don't have the technical skills of like maybe sketching very well or CADing. Yeah. So at the start it's difficult because of the learning curve, so you have to learn a lot in year one. But I think it's like, even if I come from JC, I still have my own strengths and like own perspective that I can contribute in design. Like maybe even if my strength is not in maybe the hardware or like CADing, but I do have other strengths that is still valuable to the design process. So I think being able to adapt to ID is more of whether you want to, like whether you are willing to put in the effort. Like maybe you are bad at CADing, but even if as a JC student, you can still pick it up, but as long as you work hard at it, yeah. So it's not about whether you have the skills at the start or not. It's more of, willing to work at it. Yeah, so I think one very important characteristic is like you have to have the tenacity, like the perseverance to push through. Yeah, so I think to be able to adapt at ID. Yeah.
But the other thing I think is quite different from JC study is in JC, right, quite often there's a so-called correct answer. In design, quite often there's no correct answer. Yeah. So sometimes we want you to think about things critically. We want you to justify why you want to do this, why you think about this design will be better, why it's evidence. So there's a lot of things slightly different from your past experience or from your education background. So that could be something also slightly challenging for a JC student. But it's also same as all the poly students.
Is there any more questions?
你还在问你的哦，那个是没有，他是，he
said, yeah, it's a comment.
嗯哼，你再看看有没有什么问题了，我们再回答一个。We just enter one more.
Okay,
for the merger, I think somebody asked about, I think the news announced today is talk about we will provide a much more flexible type of education system. In a way, it's allow the student are able to cater what they want. So you are able to do a second major, a minor, or a specialization much more easier. So basically, right, for this year intake, all the students come in for this August, they are able to be benefit from this change. And so it allow the student at this moment, right, allow our ID, the design student are able to choose some event, and for example, you are study ID, but you are able to become second major in mechanical engineering or in aerospace or what. So that allow the student have much more a wide breadth and then to be able to work for the industry or work for their future career much better, and then also have the freedom to learn something different. Yeah, so I think in a way it's a much more welcome type of change to the student, and then allow the student have much more room to choose what they really want. And I think it's also quite difficult for a student quite often. When you just graduate from JC, you really don't know what you want. So quite often you may just put some sort of major or some sort of course you want to study. But now because of this new opportunity, so you are able to get a second major or another minor which you think about, that's what you want as well.
I think...
Roughly, that's it.
Yeah.
Okay.
I think we try to answer.
So So I think we try to answer all the questions, and then sorry for the delay of the start, and then now it's nearly 7. So we will just finish today's section now.
Yeah.
Thank you and bye bye.
I think the next session is Wednesday, 6 PM with mm-hmm. Christian. Yeah. So you could join in the next session if you have any more questions.
Yeah. That would be our head of department.
Yeah, the head of department. Thank you.
Thank you. Bye-bye. Bye.